Hello, today I'll be covering the new reporting in Lansweeper Cloud. The new report builder in Lansweeper Cloud allows you to finally get an overview of your complete IT. So if you have multiple installations, on-premise installations spread throughout the world in your different geolocations, different departments, whatever it might be, or if you're managing multiple clients with Lansweeper, you'll now be able to report on all of your data at once without having to go to individual installations and running the same report over and over again. Additionally, we've done some significant enhancements to the reports builder to actually make it more user-friendly, allow you to create reports with more ease and without the knowledge of needing to know what SQL queries you need to create in order to get the data from your installation. So let's take a look in Lansweeper Cloud and see exactly how you could create a report. So in Lansweeper Cloud, let's head over to the reporting tab where you can already see some changes. To begin with, we've added categories to make it easier for you to find specific reports, depending on what kind of reports you're looking for, whether it be hardware, security, software, user reports. You can find them with ease now. And additionally, and importantly, we've added a specific filter as well for custom reports. So if you want to find any of your previously created reports quickly, you can do so easily by using the custom reports filter. Additionally, top right-hand corner, we also have a search box that you can use to filter on any of the reports. An example of that would be if we want to find the Patch Tuesday report that is now also in Cloud, then you can find it quickly there. These are automatically added to the installation to your site, so you can always find them here and take a look at them and look at all of the data and see whether your machines are up to date or out of date, depending on the latest Windows patches. Heading back to the overview, there's also options now to run reports, either run them immediately, if we just want to get an immediate refresh of the data. So we can either run the report now, or there are also additional options to schedule your reports. So if you want to run the reports on a specific interval or on specific days, then there are options there to do that as well. But going back to our essence here of creating reports, the report builder, let's start with creating a new report. So in the report builder, we've switched to a step-based system, and it'll become clear as I go what that means. But our first step is here to select some fields. Then we have to choose a collection. So let's just take the top collection of devices and software. That's where we want to grab some data from. And we're going to add the asset name. Let's take the asset type as well. Let's go for an IP address. Maybe a MAC address as well. And here we have to make sure that we grab the MAC address from the asset and not from a different type of data like Chrome OS or AirWatch devices. Obviously, we grab MAC addresses from multiple sources. So sometimes you'll have to make sure that you select the data from the right source that you want it from. And then the last one that we might want to add is here, asset domain. So now we hit apply, and that will give us immediately a preview of all of what our report would look like were we to save it right now. But we're not finished, so we're going to add another step. And I'll add a filter here, and I want to filter first on making sure that we filter out all of the non-Windows devices. So I'm going to go to asset type, and I want this to be equal to Windows. And as you can see, the preview updates and shows you what the report would look like if we were to save it right now. Also useful is that you can always see the previous step, so you can actually even compare the difference between what the previous step showed and what your new change has caused and has changed to your report. And the last step that we'll add is a group. So we're actually going to group by our domain. So now we get an overview of all of the domains that we have Windows computers in. And we can also have an option here to change it to account. So we actually get an overview of how many devices, how many Windows devices specifically do we have in each domain. To save this, we'll head over to the top where we have to give this report a new name. So let's call it Windows Assets Domain Overview. And then hit the save button. And then we get prompted to ask us, you know, where do you want to save this report? Which specific category? I'm just going to save it for now under the general all hardware reports category. Hit save. That will be done. It also tells you that it will be added to the running queue. So it means that it will be executed right away. And here we get our final result of the report with some additional options at the top right. So if you want to, you can still export your data. You know, if you want a manual export somewhere, or you can duplicate the report to adjust it, make changes to it, use it as kind of a template to work on later on. Obviously, the edit buttons and the, you know, scheduling your report, running it and deleting it are all there as well. Now that we've created the report, we can even use it on our dashboard so that everyone can take a look at it, and then you can always see it when you start up or log into your cloud site. So here on the dashboard, we're quickly going to edit our default dashboard, add a new widget. We have a data report that we want to add, which we called Windows Assets Domain Overview. There it is. Add that. And then at the bottom, here we have our new widget with our report results in it. And seeing as there's a little scroll bar in there, let's extend it a bit so that it actually shows all of the data that we want in one view without a scroll bar. There we go. As with any of the other widgets, there's full control over where you want these widgets, what the naming is. You know, if I'd like to replace it with one of these, put it there, I can. And you have full size control as well, so you can change how large or small they are. So let's save the board here, head back, and then we see it in the middle of our dashboard here as well. I hope this introduction of the new report builder has given you a good glimpse of how you can use the new report builder to report on data across your entire IT organization and make better use of it. So thank you for watching.